Our next port of call is Doxa Medical Laboratories Limited, situated within a small shopping complex in Kujay, a satellite town in the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. Incorporated in December 2014 to engage in diagnostic services, Doxa Laboratories now offers hematology, serology, microbiology and chemistry tests, as well as hormonal assays, ultrasound, ECG and X-ray services. The chief promoter, Mr. Opafe Iwalefo, tells us about the impact of BOI's intervention on the business.
I remember my first experience sometimes in 2012 here in Fuji. I had someone who was very close to me who had appendicitis, and then we had severe pain in the lower abdomen, and we needed to do an ultrasound for him. And we're in Fuji here, we couldn't get anywhere to do it. We referred to a location that took over 45 minutes to get there. And from then, the idea of setting up a medical laboratory and diagnostic center came out of my heart. And I saw that opportunity and I knew it was the right decision to take.
How and when did it come about, the Bank of Industry?
I'm a fan of the BoI weekly program with Channel TV. I could actually source for funds for my business through the program. But I've always had this perception that Bank of Industry funds mega businesses, so, and that probably their conditions might be too difficult for a startup like me to meet, until there was this program run by the Ministry of Trade and Investment, the ESP, supervised by the Bank of Industry. We applied, submitted a detailed business proposal, went through the steps, and came out successful.
Some people have complained that the process of accessing BOI's loans is very difficult. I'd like to know what your own experience was.
Even though we came through a program, a federal government sponsored program, and I know a lot of the bar was actually lowered for small businesses like us to be able to access the funds. You know, we also had a lot of expectation, coming from where we were. We wanted it to be, we thought we could get it faster. We thought because we're coming from the government, entrepreneurship sponsorship program, we'll get a lot of waivers, But eventually we still had to go through the same process, get guarantors, do a lot of financials, But these stars were quite helpful. A lot of wonderful people that they helped us to actually do meet the requirement that we're supposed to meet.
So tell me more, what's been the basic impact of the whole intervention?
Before the Bank of Industry intervened in our business, even though we had the capacity to run a full-fledged diagnostic center, we restricted ourselves to just running laboratory services. So when we came to the Bank of Industry, we asked for funds to the tune of $5 million. That was about the highest we could ask for, from our program, to buy some machines, the ultrasound machine, the electrocardiogram machine for the center.
I'm just curious, you had the opportunity to get two sets of equipment from BOI. The first one you got was an ultrasound machine. Why was the second one a heart examination equipment? Is there a pattern here in Kujay of repeated cases that require that examination?
We should understand Kujay as a satellite town. Now, Kujay, the population of Kujay is over 400,000, and then we have people of different age strata. We have the old, the young, and then that for people who are above 40, 50, some are diabetic, some have heart-related issues. We just don't want a situation where people want to do heart examinations, they can't do it. You know, you have people falling down with stroke every time. If we can help, why not?
Under what funds did you obtain the intervention? And I'd like you to explain the structure.
It's a 3.5-year term loan with a 6-month moratorium. What that means for us is, okay, we got a loan offer of $5 million to kickstart the diagnostic sector of our business, and then we have 3.5-year repayment plan, you know, to meet, and then but for the first 6 months we are not expected to pay the capital of the loan, so it gave us enough time to settle down, do a lot of market work, and then before we start repaying in full. With the fund we had, we were only able to buy 2 major equipment. One is the 4D Mindray DC30 ultrasound machine for ultrasound services, and then the ECG machine. These are the 2 machines we got. The ECG machine evaluates the structure and function of the heart. The ultrasound machine, the 4D ultrasound machine, it's not anywhere near here. It does all possible ultrasound examinations.
Can you further explain the purpose and impact of each of the set of equipment that you got through the intervention of the Bank of England?
Before now in Kuji, when you want to do ultrasound, you want to take ultrasound examination and you want to run laboratory services, you will have to move from go to one lab, do your blood testing, go to some distance again to do the ultrasound examination. But we had a dream, and our vision was to run a one-stop shop where you could actually do your lab testing services and also run your ultrasound examination if you require them. So I believe, and then with the technology we brought here, because this is the first 4D ultrasound machine here in Kuji, patients are able to actually see for themselves, you know, not just the doctor telling them your baby is okay. They're able to see the fetal heart beat themselves. They're able to see even the gender, you know, the doctor shows them, you know, they see it for themselves. That's what we wanted to bring it up, because people have this perception about ultrasound examination. They just believe results are either manipulated or just given to you, because when you come in, they ask you when was your last menstrual cycle, and then they feel, you know, people just calculate their EDD based on, you know, their last menstrual cycle date they've given. But here in this center, they're able to see it for themselves, the evaluation, the measurement, the baby. And I think that is one edge we have about our scientists.
What's been the most exciting part of your journey to the bank of industry?
The most exciting part of our engagement is the fact that we can actually see our business growing. We see that we are getting closer to fulfilling our vision for those medical laboratories. And on a day-to-day basis, we are witnessing the growth of our client base. People are coming from everywhere. They want to take their examinations here, both their laboratory examinations and their ultrasound examinations. It's a joy for us that we're able to come in and deliver exactly what we should be doing.
What will be your own feedback to the Bank of Industry?
Well, I've always believed that nothing good comes easy. You have to work for whatever you get. I know the procedures with the Bank of Industry are not. I'm glad they're able to support small businesses like ours, and I honestly want them to keep supporting young entrepreneurs like me. I know there are so many of them outside who want to, you know, take advantage of this platform. I sincerely want them to keep supporting young entrepreneurs.
Is there any likelihood that you'll go back to the bank of industry?
Oh, we sincerely love to, because at the moment we are still not where we want to be. We still want to run, like I said, our dream is to run a full-fledged diagnostic center. We want to be able to do digital X-ray services. Right now we are not doing that, and hopefully we should go back to the bank of industry.